Hey guys, it's Sean with Inspire EV, and it was time for me to upgrade old Shaky, my 1984 Turo snowblower, and I decided to go electric. Check it out.
After a lot of research, I settled on the Ego Power Plus 24-inch self-propelled two-stage snowblower. Now, I ordered it from acmetools.com because this came as a set with the two batteries and the charger included, where other websites were selling the snowblower and the chargers separately. When you do the math, you end up saving about $150 to $200 if you can get the free shipping option like I did. The snowblower arrived in less than 7 days, and I was excited to start unpacking it. Total assembly took well under an hour, and really, I didn't have to use any tools. It pretty much came with everything you needed to put it together. Now I have to admit, I really like the looks. I like the fact that it looks like a normal snowblower, but for most, you can tell something's different. Now the batteries have this really cool feature where the test light is right on top of them, and they work either on the charger or off the charger, so you can always tell if your batteries are fully charged or not. So unfortunately, they didn't come charged, and there's no snow, so time to charge the batteries.
Now the good news is, in Colorado, it doesn't take long until we get a snowstorm.
Now the first thing I noticed is it's a lot louder than I expected it to be. For some reason, I thought it was going to be completely quiet. The second thing is it's not scraping the concrete and it's leaving a little layer of snow underneath. So I think I need to go back and adjust the pads. I didn't want to do it right now because it is -3 degrees out as I'm filming. I do wish the adjustment for the direction of the snow was on the handle instead of on the machine, where you have to take your hand off of the drive motor in order to change it. It gets a little annoying and slows you down. You can see that there's plenty of power. It's throwing the snow easily 50 feet and hitting my neighbor's house. Now this is really light and fluffy snow, so we hope it'll do this when it's heavy, wet, springtime snow too. Now you can also see it's leaving a little trail of snow behind. I don't know if this is an adjustment that needs to be made, or if this is just what this snow blower does. Either way, it's easy to just go back and clean it up really quick. So overall, I'm really impressed with this snowblower. I am still interested to see how long these batteries are going to last and how the cold affects the batteries long term. I have a 3-car driveway plus the sidewalk, and it looks like this thing had no problem at all handling this with a little bit of gas still in the tank, as they say. But we'll see how it goes long term, as I'll keep using this all winter long and keep you up to date. Thank you.